Hi everyone, today I will tell you about an interesting topic, which is pure substance phase change. We all know that there are three principal phases, which is solid, liquid, and gas. But how does one phase change to another phase? For example, the water appears as a mixture of liquid and vapor in the boiler. So we will cover this topic to reveal the phase change process of pure substance. One of the clear applications in this modern world is pressure cooker. How these two things can be related? Before that, let's hear, what is pressure cooker? Today, we want to discuss our topic of thermodynamics is pressure cooker. In history, pressure cooking is a method of cooking in a sieve vessel, not permitting steam to escape below a preset pressure. Because the boiling point of water increases as the pressure increases, the pressure builds up the cooker allows the liquid in the cooking pot to rise to the higher pressure of the boiler. The pressure cooker was invented by Denis Papin, a French physicist, and in 1679. However, it only became a household cooking appliance during World War II, when the people realized how much fuel they could save due to much shorter cooking time and the ability to keep a cut of meal easily. Pressure cooking is often used to stimulate the effect of long braising or simmering in shorter period of time. Today we now are using an electric pressure cooker. This consists of a pressure cooking container, the electric heating element, and temperature or pressure sensor. The whole process forms a closed loop control system in engineering term. The principle is similar to that the cruise control found in many cars these days. The users put all the ingredients in the cooking pot and sets the pressure cooking duration for the type of food to be cooked. The electric pressure cooker does the rest. I wonder, how does the pressure cooker works? What? You don't know how to use pressure cooker? How pressure cooker works? Never mind. I will help you after this. But let me finish my cook first, okay? Okay, wait for me. I found a love for me. Darling, just dive right in. Follow my. Hello everyone, firstly I will tell you about how the pressure cooker works. Pressure cooker works by forming an airtight seal, so when the liquid comes to a boil, the pressure will build up. You understand? Okay, firstly I will tell you about the basic part, pressure cooker. What we have is pressure regulator, releasing valve, cover lock, handle and body. This is the basic part. Without I mention which type of the pressure cooker, because the pressure cooker also have many type. Okay, then I will tell you how to use the pressure cooker. Firstly, when we want to use the pressure cooker, just put whatever we want to cook in the pressure cooker. This is fish, meat and chicken, and also add a little water. Usually about half of the pressure cooker. After we put all the ingredient that we want to cook, just put the lid on the pressure cooker and lock to ensure the pressure is in the cooker, and then turn on the fire to start cooking. And then before that, we need to set the pressure regulator to set how much pressure we need to cook
when we have finished cook all the food, first we need to do is turn off the fire and then release out all the steam from the pressure cooker to ensure the condition for the pressure cooker is safe. It's dangerous to open pressure cooker when the pressure is still high in the cooker. Do you know, by using pressure cooker, we also can make a bomb just by inserting nails, explosive and glass debris into the pressure cooker, the bomb can be made. So if you don't want your pressure cooker become a bomb, never exceed the pressure that have limit by the pressure cooker. Okay, that's all. Thank you.
Meanwhile,
now I will talk about the principles of thermodynamics that involve in pressure cooker, which is phase change processes of pure substances, which is stress on temperature and pressure. Basically, pressure cooker was use water to boil food. We know that water boils at 100 degrees Celsius at 180 m. So when we start to boil, the temperature increases as well as the pressure increases. Also increases according to the pressure law, which stated that for a given mass and constant volume of an ideal gas, the pressure exerted on the sides of its container is directly proportional to its absolute pressure. We also can refer to the ideal gas law, PV equals to RT. Since volume remains constant in this case, thus temperature increases, pressure also will increase. Firstly, the beginning of the process in pressure cooker, when the water starts to boil, which indicates as in stage 1, which heat transfers until it reaches 100 degrees Celsius. At this point, the water is still in liquid form. But as the heat keeps flow, the liquid is changing to vaporize. That is a phase change process from liquid to vapor, which is called saturated liquid. Next, at second phase, as it continually transferring heat, the vaporization process continues until the last drop of liquid is vaporized. Heat loss from this vapor will cause some of the vapor to condense, which is called saturated vapor. Excess heat continues to boil as the pressure is increasing, resulting in superheated vapor. It takes large amount of energy to vaporize a liquid. The amount of energy absorbed during a phase change process is called latent heat. So what happened during the process when pressure cooker absorbs such amount of energy is called latent heat of vaporization, and the energy released during condensation are equivalent. In conclusion, T saturated will increase with P saturated. Thus, a substance at higher pressure boils at higher temperatures. Hence, higher boiling point temperature means shorter cooking times and saving lots of energy.
A few moments later.
Now, I want to talk about the importance of pressure cooker. The food that we cook using pressure cooker able to hold its vitamins and minerals since it requires only a short period of time to cook. Second, the importance of pressure cooker is also energy efficiency. So we could use only less electricity to cook our food since it takes lesser time to cook compared to normal cooking. Third, with the pressure cooker, it could save our times a lot since we just put all the necessary ingredients in the pressure cooker and we can leave it in the period of time. We can use the time to do other things. Fourth, our cooking atmosphere will be less heat. Since heat is trapped inside the pressure cooker, the result our food will be more quality. Lastly, our kitchen will be more tidier and cleaner since no food splattering around, and our dish is safe since it is sealed in the pot. Next, I will talk about how people live without pressure cooker in the past. In the past, before pressure cooker was invented, there is a scientist named Dennis Papin who is a physicist and a mathematician. He created a huge cast iron with a fitted lid that can be tightly locked. This device is known as steam digester. How does the steam digester work? As they insert raw materials such as bones and meat in the cast iron, water is filled out and the cast iron is locked tightly with the lid. The cast iron is heated until water reaches its boiling temperature. At this high temperature, meat and bones can be softened and cooked in a short period of time. Later on, Dennis Papin, he added a valve on top of the lid for the extra pressure to be released. Without the valve in the previous his invention, there are many explosions occur and consumers difficult to control the pressure. Thank you.
That's all from us.
Thank you.
Okay. Blah, 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 blah.